Brothers ask that if a person is going towards knowledge, can Shaitan make the person ill? Can he make ill? So we see, let us look at it this way. A person is becoming more and more righteous and good. Can Shaitan try to make him ill and sick and trouble him? We have looked at it different ways. Firstly, can Shaitan make a person ill? Let's leave righteous part aside. So yes, Shaitan can affect a person. They also have difficulties to do that. As we know, Allah has put angels for protecting people and special angels for protecting Muslims and believers. So he will have to go through all of those difficulties to trouble someone. So generally, they don't come in trouble, but there are exceptional cases when they do come in trouble. So a person should not fall into waswasa that this Shaitan has done. Just leave that. Even if he was there, don't give him credit. Read your askar and go in protection and go ahead. If it is there are ways to treat it also. Alhamdulillah. So what happens is, number one is, can they affect? Yes, they can affect, but they also have to go through a lot of difficulties to come and affect. It's not a cakewalk for the shayateen also, jinns. From the basis of the Quran and the Sunnah, we can tell. It's not so easy for them also. Second thing is that a person is becoming righteous. He's going for ilm. He's becoming better. Then Shaitan, can he come and affect the person while he's becoming better? While he's better, no, let us consider someone is very good. So the better you get, the more difficult it becomes for him to trouble you. The more iman, the more tougher it is for him to trouble you. If you, for example, see the magic done by Labid bin Asim, the magician, on Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in the commentary of the hadith, it's been explained that that had only a very small minor effect, that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would think that I have gone to my wife when he's not gone. Something which was halal, which going to the wife. It was not something haram he would think that I've done. Something halal. But it was small trivial trouble. That's it, trivial. But the magic was, this was like, why was it? Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was the most righteous. But Allah wanted the Ummah to get an example about what to do when there's this happens. And the people of commentary, they've explained that the magic done was of a very heavy nature, but it affected the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to a very trivial degree. And that was also so that we get the answer about what we should do, and we should look at the example of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So the more stronger your iman becomes, the tougher it is for the shaitan to trouble you. But it is possible, Allah has willed a test for you to go to a higher degree. See, Allah at times has a degree Allah wants that person to reach. In Sahih al-Jami, there's a hadith that Allah has at times decided that Allah wants a person to reach this level. But he's not going there by his deeds. By his deeds, he's not reaching that level. So then Allah Ta'ala ordains for him difficulties. In those difficulties, he does sabr. And by doing sabr, he reaches that level finally. So we find that there is something good in everything for a believer. So can it happen? It is possible also. It is difficult for the shaitan, but it is possible also. What should we do? Number one, avoid assumptions over there also. Don't give credit. Even if you think it's confirmed, read askar and don't think too much about it. Read your zikr and askar. Read surah Falak, surah Nas with conviction and iman. And don't think too much about it. See brothers, what I give people, what I want to tell people, is you realize the strength of iman. And with the strength of iman, you can bring that shaitan to the level that he is. And then you can easily deal with it. If you don't have that part, then you're dealing with a big giant. So it's tough for you. You bring him down to his reality. As the Prophet ﷺ said, kal zubab, like a fly. Then deal with it. Don't make a mountain out of him and deal with him. So that's the thing that is very important in this. So if someone says, a fly has come in my house, Sheikh, what should I do to deal with it? So we said, deal with it, come on, what's the problem? Don't get troubled with the fly.